敬拜我们的神。今天我想邀请需要得医治的人，就是我们上面打的这些需要得医治的人，如果你们今天想要神的医治，就到前面来，因为神他今天要赐下喜乐在你们的里面。因为喜乐的灵是什么？是良药，他是医治全体的良药。哈利路亚，他的爱和恩典大过一切。
上帝正在为了你和我征战，他已得着胜利，与我们同在，我们不会动摇，也不会害怕，祝你在身旁。
神在他们生命中所做美好的事情，以至于我们要把感谢荣耀归给神。我们要来欢迎第一位是亮莹，来说说耶稣为你做了什么。哇，耶稣改变他的眼光，可以用有尊荣的眼光去看待每一个人。一真，
耶稣给我意想不到的爱。
哇，耶稣给他意想不到的爱。月影，
感谢耶稣救我脱离痛苦，他带我离开了黑暗入光明。
阿们。哈利路亚，耶稣是赐光明的神。婉心，
谢谢耶稣坚强我的信心，让我不再担心受怕。
阿们。耶稣使他有信心，不再害怕。子后，
谢谢耶稣帮我找到我的钱包，还有给我现在的生活。
有听到吗？好，来子维。
耶稣给予我梦想，然后带领我经过低潮。耶稣，我爱你。
耶，哇！紫薇很热情哦。好，坤达。
感谢神在我的行为上以同频率的方式记号着，让我相信 God is good all the time。
阿妹，坤达是神，是良善的神。念宗，
谢谢耶稣，让我的心里有盼望。
哇，耶稣是使人有盼望的神。海荣。
感谢耶稣，他医治了我的心。
哇，简洁有力，耶稣是医治的神。好吧，我们再一次的掌声欢迎他们，今天就要在我们当受洗，请你们就受洗的位置，我们再一起来敬拜我们的神。哈利路亚，
哈利路亚。
这绝不是表演，不唱空洞语言，我敬拜在你面前，不是追求感觉，而用诚实谦卑，我歌唱因你恩典。
Come on， 开口赞美他。
我只想要歌唱，用我全心来颂扬，只为你我的君王。哦，人或许不明白，为何我唱这么嗨，你配得最高敬拜。哦，
好吧，拍手来唱。
求完美，而我用心体会，我愿献上我一切，超越唱一首歌的时间，我一生敬拜在你面前。若我要歌唱，我目的很明显，唯有你配得所有赞美。用我全心来颂扬，只为你我的君王。哦，人或许不明白，为何我唱这么嗨，你配得最高敬拜。
1, 2, 3, go!
是为你我的君王。
你真的是伟大的神，主要无论在我们的生命当中经历到什么我们认为是巨大的东西，主你都大过那件事情。主你是伟大的神，主你永远站立，主你永远坚定，主没有人可以动摇你。主让我们来敬拜你，主让我们来高举你，主因为你是永不动摇的神。
你将海洋都放在你手里，地球对你就像一颗沙粒，你是神，直到永远，你都不改变。你衡量高山低谷到地极，从山出入灰尘在你量起，你是神。永远你都不改变，我主站立，站立到永远，我主站立，站立到永远，我高山我低谷你永远在我身边，我主站立，站立到永远，站立到永远。我们不会退缩，勇敢向前，重新的理智引信号跟随，你是神，
直到永远，
直到永远。无一事物能够与你相比，你胜过一切，超好棒！
高举我们的双手来唱，
无一事物能够与你相比，你存到永远，你的爱无限，无一事物能够与你相比。永远，我高山我低谷你永远在我身边，我主站立，站立到永远，我主站立，站立到永远，
我主，
我主站立，站立到永远。我高山我低谷在我身边。
我们坚定的那一位神，主我们赞美你，主我们来敬拜你。哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚。好吧，我来读一段圣经，在诗篇第五十七篇第七节那个地方说：神啊，我的心坚定，我的心坚定，我要歌唱，我要颂赞，我的灵啊，你要醒过来，情和色啊，你们都要醒过来，我也要唤醒黎明。主啊，我要在万民中称谢你，在万族中歌颂你，因为你的慈爱伟大，高及诸天，你的信实上达云霄。神啊，愿你被尊崇，过于诸天，愿你的荣耀遍及全地。今天晚上，当我们来到神的面前的时候，不管我们带着什么样子的心情，不管在这个礼拜我们经历到什么样的事情，我们仍然宣告我们的神是得胜的神，我们仍然宣告神的爱是胜过一切所有死亡阴间恐惧的权势，一切所有的分化在他的爱里面要归为无有。我们的神是爱我们的神，我们的神是那位良善的天父，我们仍然要来赞美他，我们的心仍然要来坚定，让你的心苏醒过来，让你的灵苏醒过来，来赞美你的神，来赞美你的神，他必坚定直到永远。哈利路亚，他的爱是永远不失败的爱。所以今天晚上当我们聚在他面前的时候，我们欢迎他的同在。主圣灵，我们欢迎你更多的降临在我们的当中。哈利路亚，主啊，你的天堂敞开，
在你荣耀里，你荣耀里。
哦，亲爱神灵，来点燃我心，焚烧我灵，焚烧我灵，在你同在里，主我将不在你荣耀里，你荣耀里，我虽唱歌永留在我心，
我的真爱努力，出生
胜利火焰，焚烧在我心，当我呼叫你歌唱爱慕你，主生灵火焰焚烧在我心，当我呼求你名，当我呼求你名，
这个就是我们宣告你的名大有能力。主，当我们宣告你的名的时候，主，你的国就降临在我们的当中，而你的国是在圣灵的里面。主，今天晚上当我们聚集在你面前的时候，主，我们不但享受你的同在，我们来看见你，主，你自己的灵运行自由的在我们的当中。主，今天晚上我们也要来庆祝，你说那宣告你名的就必得救。今天晚上有九位弟兄姐妹来到你的面前，他们不但要受洗归入你的名下，他们不但要受水的洗，他们要受属天的洗。耶稣基督，你今天晚上要用圣灵与火为他们来施洗，他不但归入在这个大家庭的里面，他们成为你的儿女，他们要成为你国度的精兵。耶稣，我谢谢你，赞美你，今天晚上不但用水为他们施洗，用火用圣灵为他们施洗。好吧，我们可以回到我们的座位，我们可以坐下来。今天晚上的第一位跟第二位，第一位是林亮颖姐妹，她是可口可乐小组的，她想要对她的家人跟朋友说的一句话就是，神真的是非常超级无敌好的爸爸，超乎我们想象中的良善。我很努力的在改变自己，成为合神心意的样子，也希望我们能够一同在神的同在里一起改变。第二位是李一珍，然后呢，他是 Go to D 小组的，谢谢家人们，他想要对他的家人说，谢谢家人们尊重我的信仰选择，愿你们能够慢慢的了解神的爱，也谢谢怀恩带领我来到灵粮堂。
李一珍姐妹，你是否愿意接受耶稣基督成为你个人的救主和生命的主？
我愿意。
林亮颖姐妹，你是否愿意接受耶稣基督成为你个人的救主及生命的主？
我愿意。
你既是愿意，我奉圣父、圣子、圣灵的名为你施洗，使你归入主耶稣基督的名下，从今时直到永远。阿们。
哈利路亚。好，第三位是曾月红姐妹，她是美乐蒂小组的，她想要对家人跟朋友所说的是，在往后的日子，我希望我们能够一起信主，当神的儿女。第四位是林婉欣姐妹，她是贝加小组的，她想要对家人说，谢谢妹妹带领我进入主的怀抱。
林婉欣姐妹，你是否愿意接受耶稣基督成为你个人的救主和生命的主？
曾月莹姐妹，你是否愿意接受耶稣基督成为你个人的救主及生命的主？
我愿意。
你既是愿意，我奉圣父、圣子、圣灵的名为你施洗，使你归入主耶稣基督的名下，从今时直到永远。阿们。
哈利路亚，感谢主。好，接下来呢，我们有五位弟兄。他们要受洗，所以所有的弟兄为他们欢呼。这一次我们的弟兄比姐妹还要多，感谢主，多一个，嘿嘿。好，第五位张子厚弟兄，他是发光小组的，他想要对家人跟朋友说，谢谢你们在我困难的时候帮助我。然后呢，第六位是王子维弟兄，他是兴起小组的，他说，我要感谢在我身边一直支持我爱我的朋友、家人跟父母，你们是我继续坚持进步的动力来源。
王子维弟兄，你是否愿意接受耶稣基督成为你个人的救主和生命的主？
我愿意。
张子厚弟兄，你是否愿意接受耶稣基督成为你个人的救主及生命的主？
我愿意。
你既是愿意，我奉圣父、圣子、圣灵的名为你施洗，使你归入主耶稣基督的名下，从今时直到永远。阿们。
哈利路亚。OK， 第七位是谢坤达弟兄，他是志成歌小组的，他想要对家人说谢谢这一切的引领。然后呢，第八位是尤念宗弟兄，他是家友小组的，然后他想对家人朋友说，爱里没有惧怕，爱既完全就把惧怕除去。
尤念宗弟兄，你是否愿意接受耶稣基督成为你个人的救主和生命的主？
我愿意。
谢坤达弟兄，你是否愿意接受耶稣基督成为你个人的救主及生命的主？
我愿意。
你既是愿意，我奉圣父、圣子、圣灵的名为你施洗，使你归入主耶稣基督的名下，从今时直到永远。阿们。
哈利路亚，感谢主。好，最后一位呢是汪海荣弟兄，他是 Omega 小组的，然后他想要对家人朋友说，当你那天走到人生的尽头的时候，请试着跟神说说话。
汪海荣弟兄，你是否愿意接受耶稣基督成为你个人的救主和生命的主？
我愿意。
你既是愿意，我奉圣父、圣子、圣灵的名为你施洗，使你归入主耶稣基督的名下，从今时直到永远。阿们。
低头来祷告，祝福这些弟兄姐妹。亲爱的天父，我们来到你的面前，主，我谢谢你，因为你是良善的父，因着你的良善吸引他们归向你。主，今天他们不再是旧人，而变成新人了。因为若有人在基督里，他就是新造的人，旧事已过，都变成新的。主，今天我们祷告，有一个新的旅程要开始了，有一个新的信心、新的勇气，最重要也是有一个新的恩膏，使他们能够继续的持守走在耶稣基督的道路当中。主，我们谢谢你，我们奉你的名要祝福他们，每一天每一天越来越像你，每一天每一天更加的爱你，而且一生走在你的道路当中。听我们这样的祷告及祝福，是奉靠主耶稣基督的名求，阿们。
也再一次恭喜我们这些的家人，哈利路亚。哈利路亚，在这边我要代表台北灵粮堂青年牧区来欢迎我们当中，如果你是第一次、第二次来我们当中的新朋友，待会到我数到三的时候，邀请你从你位置上站起来，让我们给你一个最热烈的欢迎。预备好了吗？一、二、三，新朋友请起立。好，二楼有没有？哈利路亚！刚才你站起来的时候，我们招待的弟兄姐妹有把一份小资料递到你的手上，在里面有一份留名卡。我邀请你从把留名卡拿出来，花一两分钟的时间来填写这份留名卡。然后待会当我们收奉献的时候呢，你可以把留名卡放在奉献袋里面，让我们教会可以进一步的认识你。里面还有一张 VIP 的贴纸，记得把这个 VIP 的贴纸贴在你身上。今天你就是我们当中的 VIP。当我们聚会结束的时候呢，在外面219，我们有一个VIP 的接待室，专门为你预备的，让你在那个地方可以接受我们的祝福祷告，也可以让你更多的认识我们的教会。好，接下来我要邀请嘉音姐来收今天晚上的奉献，我们一起拍掌来欢迎嘉音姐。
耶、yeah, ，让我们一起在神的同在里面来读神的话。我们来看一下，在箴言书第三章9-10，我们一起来读。来，好，来，我们一起来。我以财物和一切出手的土产尊荣耶和华，这样你的仓房必充满有余，你的酒榨有新酒盈溢。弟兄姐妹，我们的神非常乐意把一切所有的丰盛赏赐给我们，让我们能够参与管理跟使用。当我们以神为中心，我们愿意让神居首位的时候，你知道你的心里面就会有一个渴望，你想要走在神的心意当中，包括在一切所有的包含你的财务上面去尊荣神。但是如果我们是以自己为中心呢，我们就常常会顺着自己的思想，顺着自己的私欲想要来过生活。这张纸呢代表着财务，你知道当我们按着我们的想要去过生活的时候呢，我们往往会想要这样子做， 哇，我要先缴我的手机费，然后呢可能又想到，对哦，我每一天都要吃东西，然后最近呢感恩节到圣诞节有大打折，所以我要购买新衣服化妆品，然后想着说嗯，对，如果我是社青的话，我就会想到我还要缴什么房贷，然后我还有孩子的尿布，然后呢最近呢太多红色炸弹，我还要包红包，然后呢我还要休闲，然后呢可能我还要去运动，到最后呢神，我还有剩一些些，我还可以给你，你看吧，我对你还不错吧。嘿，弟兄姐妹，我要告诉你，神不需要你的钱，你知道神非常看重跟你的关系，他非常在乎我们的心，我们的态度，你是否也看重你跟神的关系呢？你是否愿意让神在你的生命当中居首位？你是否愿意用你生命的一切来尊荣这位神呢？当我们愿意的时候，当我们愿意让神在我们的里面完全居首位的时候，我们会愿意走在神的心意里面，而我们会经历到上帝给我们的应许跟祝福。好吧，我们再一次把这一段经我们再一次读一遍，来，你要以财物和一切出手的土产尊荣耶和华，这样你的仓房必充满有余，你的酒榨有新酒盈溢。好吧，让我们一起来祷告。爱我们的天父，我们谢谢你，你是如此的爱我们，你乐意赐福我们，求你来帮助我们调整我们的心，调整我们的态度，让我们愿意在凡事上面能够让你居首位，让我们在爱里面来尊荣你。谢谢你，祷告乃是奉耶稣基督的圣名，阿们。让我们一起来奉献。
好，就在我们奉献的时候也特别注意一下我们一些的报告事项，我们一起来欢迎我们报告的影片。
弟兄姐妹平安，欢迎来到青年牧区今天的报告时间。要跟大家讲一个装备课程的消息，就是呢叫做宣教，现在正是时候，由我们的黄奇慧牧师还有周训真牧师为大家上课，时间呢是在12月10号星期六上午的9点到12点，地点在宣教大楼1楼大堂，保证你来上课之后你会更明白父神对宣教的心意，了解全球的宣教现况，还有我们教会所做的这些宣教的事工，欢迎大家赶快上网来报名哦，宣教正是时候耶、
Hello， 明年我们要开了一个新的课程，就是超自然绘画研习营。我们首次邀请到 School of Creative Genius 的执行长 Lin， 他要来跟我们分享他如何研究历史学上那些天才学家他们的思考模式，还有他们的潜能，然后进而激发出我们内心的创作灵感。然后他要让真的是每一个认为自己不会画画的人，他要破除这个谎言，让我们每一个人都可以成为真实的创作家。赶快上 Asia for Jesus 的网站报名，时间是1月13号礼拜五晚上的7点到9点，还有1月14号礼拜六早上10点到下午4点，地点在林良山庄106教室，等你哦。
最喜欢吃哪一间早午餐？
好，
三二一，学校。
最喜欢的 dancer 是谁？来哦，三二一，郭德正。
你怎么会答？
怎么会答？
最难忘哪一次 big day 的表演？一、二、三，
奥运会。
哪一年啊？
那不是 B 站，是 B 站吗？
那我先讲啊。
你最喜欢自己的哪里？一、二、三，
全部。
你这也是身体全部的这种。
下周我们又回到了天国频率的第五篇信息，信中欧巴要来分享确认他声音的呼召。
也就是让我们能够确认神的声音。你知道吗？很多人都会来找牧者或是领袖说，神对我说了什么，或者我从神那里领受了什么。但是我想要问的是，你怎么会知道或是确定那真的是神在对你说的吗？信中哥会教导我们如何非常实际的来查验跟确认神的声音，相信我们在这方面会更加的成熟跟健康。这周我们会进入到学生手册第六课的读书进度，在小组的当中一起来探讨先知的角色。你会发现有着先知职分的人在教会的责任，可能跟你过去所想所认知的非常不一样哦。你若是还没有买这本书或是学生手册的，现在绝对来得及，因为学习成为先知性的百姓跟活出先知性文化是一辈子的事哦。赶快加入先知学校的行列吧。
好，在我们邀请今天讲员来之前，我们还有另外一个影片跟下个礼拜的感恩节是有关系的一个影片，好不好？我们一起拍掌来欢迎这个感恩节的影片。
我就会想到他那个叫声很特别，
觉得他很可怜，很想要吃他。
土耳其吧，
想到最近一直在爆炸的手机。
嘉义火鸡肉饭，
火鸡大餐吧，感恩节晚餐。
Thanksgiving maybe。
12月25啊？
不是啦，
其实我不太清楚。
10月是10号吗？不是
，November。
11月的第四个星期四。
我想要感谢我生命中的一个很重要的老师，在我沮丧或者是过度膨胀自己的时候，一直在提点的我。
最近最感谢的是我的未婚夫，因为他每天载我上下班，让我很感动。
爸爸妈妈，因为我觉得我人生当中，我爸爸就是我的启发者，然后我妈妈就是我的支持者。
我想要感谢我的小组长。因为之前有段时间状况不是很好，然后有各式各样的负面情绪，例如说沮丧、挫折，然后甚至愤怒、悲伤等等。对，但是他就是非常的包容我。
我爸妈都让我没有后顾之忧，然后让我可以慢慢的摸索我的未来。所以想到这件事情，就真的很感谢他们。
我先生咯。就是有了孩子之后，在家成为我们经济的支柱，很辛苦。
我很感谢我父母，然后因为他们在我成长的过程，他们给我很多很快乐的童年。
爸爸妈妈，对，就是感谢他们，就是含辛茹苦。
我要感谢我太太，这个时候刚好感谢她，因为其实她20几岁就嫁给我，到现在快30年嘞，看不出来对不对？
那想感谢上帝，谢谢我们的老板让我有工作的能力，有收入。
最想要感谢的是我老公。因为我觉得他很顾家，给我一个很完整的家。
想要感恩我的学生们，我刚在国中教书的时候，每天回家都好想哭哦。我心里想，我为什么要来教这种班？可是你知道，后来他们是最让我感动的。然后经过这20多年啊，其实他们都长大了，因为我是单身嘛，所以反而是他们带着孩子，然后开着车子，然后带我到哪里去玩。
谢谢哦。
谢谢，
谢谢
哦，谢谢，
阿里多，感谢，
谢谢
，thank，
谢谢，
阿里卡多 ，thank，
感谢哈密达，
感谢哦，
谢谢，
谢谢导护老师每天早上很早就来帮我们注意我们的安全，
谢谢邮差叔叔每天帮我们送信。
谢谢清洁人员每天帮我们收臭臭的垃圾。
好，这时候我们要一起来欢迎今天来到我们当中分享的这位欧巴，我们特别要欢迎 Peter 牧师来到我们当中来分享神的话，我们一起拍掌来欢迎 Peter 哥在我们当中来分享。
欧巴，
借我一点。
Oh, sorry.
谢谢。
Well, it's so good to be back here.
很开心回到青松。
回到这里真的是回到家的感觉。真的是，你知道我每次来到这边，看到你们的敬拜，看到你们的投入，看到你们的疯狂，看到你们的，你知道每个人在敬拜的时候，脸就会特别的帅，特别的漂亮。And我觉得你们真的是一群非常非常会接待神同在 的一个牧区，我真的是很感谢每一次来到这边，可以有这样的一个机会跟你们分享。And so sorry, you need to do your job, I need to do my job. So, 那过去the last 都已经把人家叫上台了，一定要让人家有事情做嘛，对不对 ？The last The last 2 weeks, I was in Guatemala.
过去两周呢，我在瓜地马拉。
And as you guys know, Pastor John shared how 台北灵堂 we started a church in Guatemala.
那大家也都听过训政牧师跟我们分享台北灵堂在瓜地马拉开始了一间教会。
And he shared about all the grace, all the favor that was involved in the situation and getting the church started.
讲到说我们在那里设立这间教会的过程，如何的看见神的恩典在当中。
You know, we have a joke within our staff at Bread of Life International.
在我们就是英语牧区这边，我们有一个就是我们同工自己彼此间的笑话。
We say wherever Pastor John goes, favor follows.
就是不论训政牧师到哪里，就有恩典随着他。
And like if you fly with him, you get upgraded.
Fly
with them, you get upgraded.
就是你跟他一起飞的话呢，就是座位就会升等。
Yeah, and if you want to get stuff done, stuff gets done.
那你只要任何事情，你希望他完成，就是有他在，事情就会成就。
And so we started the church in April.
所以我们是四月的时候跟他去。
And right now the church is growing. They have about 100 people now.
从那个时候到现在，现在人数已经到达了100多人。
And so this time we went with our team. Some of them are actually here today. We went and we shared and we did leadership training.
然后这一次我又带着我们一些的同工，今天有在现场，我们去到瓜地马拉做了那边的领袖训练。
And God really opened up a door for us to be a light and a salt in the nation of Guatemala.
神真的让我们就是参与在当中，看见他如何在。
We got a chance this time to visit some of the top generals in the nation.
然后呢，我们这次有机会与就是在瓜地马拉国最高的一些将领聚会。
And we just got to minister to them, pray with them, and fellowship with them.
就是有机会去服侍他们，与他们有一些团契的时间。
This time we even had a chance to go to prison, not go to prison, but visit a prison.
我们这次呢，甚至有机会参访当地的监狱。
And we visit the ex-president of Guatemala, who is in prison right now.
那这个时候就是在服刑的当中，有一位是前总统，瓜地马拉前总统。
He just got put in prison last year because of corruption.
那他去年因着贪污，然后被关到下到监狱里。
And our team had the honor to share with him, to preach to him, and to pray with him.
我们的团队有荣幸服侍他，甚至为他祷告。
And just to see, you know, sometimes we like to judge people.
你知道有的时候我们会很容易去论断人。
And we label people by the mistake that they make.
我们会看着他们所行的错误，然后就贴标签在他们身上。
And yet at that moment, all we saw was a man who needed the love of God.
可是当下在我眼前，我看见不过是一个需要神爱的人。
And so we just love on him and minister to him.
所以我们就是用神的爱来爱他，服侍他。
And this time, and every time we go, we have the opportunity to go minister to the police in Guatemala.
然后呢，几乎我们每一次去也都有机会去服侍瓜地马拉。
And I think I mentioned last time, or not last time, but you know, sometime that in Guatemala, their police are extremely corrupt.
然后呢，我之前也曾经提过，瓜地马拉他们的警察就非常的贪污严重。
And many times, you know, they get trained by the state. The state pays for, you know, the training, get them to train how to use weapons and everything.
然后呢，那他们在里面会受训嘛？然后是政府会为他们付钱，教他们如何用枪。
And then the drug cartel would come in a few years later and just hire them.
然后呢，那可是又会有药头也来聘用这些警察。
Because they can pay a higher wage.
因为呢，药头付他们的薪水是比他们领的政府的薪
水还高。And if you ever go and visit where the police live, like their living headquarters.
那如果你去看他们警察的那些办公室或他们的居住环境。
You will understand why they are enticed to a life of crime.
那你就会知道为什么他们会常跟这些犯罪连在一起纠结。
Because it's just really poor condition. They don't take care of the police. There's little funding in the police.
因为呢，就是警察们他们受到照顾实在是太不好了。
And so their police has an extremely high suicide rate.
所以呢，在瓜地马拉警察有非常高的自杀率。
And a lot of them suffer with depression.
然后许多人都有忧郁症
困。And what the country, the nation decided to do, they have a policy. Because they want to prevent corruption in the police.
那政府他们怎么做？为了预防这些警察贪污。
So if you become a police, you cannot be a police in your home state or your home city.
所以他们的政策就是说，如果你要当警察，你不能在你的自己的家乡做警察。
So even though you could be married with a wife and you have kids, they would take you and put you somewhere else.
哪怕你已经结了婚有孩子，他们还是会把你直接抽离到别的地方。
And live in extremely poor condition and expect you to serve the people and to protect the society.
你所居住的环境或是宿舍是非常糟糕的环境，可是他们却期待你要照顾那个地方的百姓。
And so every single time we went, there was a lady who oversees a lot of the police ministry. She invites us to go and just minister to the police.
所以呢，每次我们去到瓜地马拉，有一位我们当中有一位姐妹，她就是照顾这些警察，她就邀请我们去服侍他们。
And the previously when we go, we get about 50.60, 70 people would come out when we go and preach.
那过去我们去的时候，通常可能就是50到70人会来到我们的聚会。
And so this year, before we went, I saw the schedule. It says police ministry. I was like, oh, I know what to expect. Okay, I know what's going on.
当我看到我们这服事的 schedule 的时候，我就想说啊，我知道这个聚会大概什么样子。
And you know, like we've done this like 2-3 times already.
因为我们已经去了两三次，我大概知道多少人。
And so we went.
我们就去。
And we were shocked.
然后我们去就吓到。
Because when we went in, they were about 50 or 60 people.
那当我们进去，我们还是吓一跳。虽然说那边的人数大概还是五六十。
And then, but all of a sudden, they start moving everything away from the building that, like all the tables and chairs, they just stop moving everything away.
可是当我们进去以后，他们就开始把所有的桌椅都往旁边搬。
And we're looking at each other, we're like, what's going on?
然后我们就看彼此说，现在是什么状况？
And we just heard like, you know, noises on the outside.
然后就发现外面就在有很多吵杂声。
And then people just start coming by the hundreds.
就是大概几百人这样涌进。
Hundreds. So we had our stage, our sound system set up.
所以呢，就这么多人涌进来，然后在台前他们就设立好音响设备。
And we had to move the sound system, I think, 2-3 times. Three times?
我们就必须要挪动那个音响设备三次。
Because we thought it was like this people, this group of people.
我们原本以为是人数大概。
And then people start coming in here. They sat here.
开始呢，有越来越多人进来，就必须要移动。
So we're like, okay, let's put one speaker here.
然后就想，哦，好，一个音响放这边。
And then people start coming in and they start sitting here.
然后又更多人进来，然后就必须要再往后移。
It took about 30 minutes for everybody to get in.
我们光是等大家所有人进来，就等了大概三十分钟。
By the end, that place was packed. We had over 850 people that came. Police officers that came.
然后那天。总共是有八百五十个警察来到我们当中。
And one thing you learn as a pastor, as a leader, is you have to show that you're very calm, even when you're not.
那做传道人的都知道，我们在台上一定要保持镇定，不管内心多么紧张。
So like there's a few team members just kind of looking at me like, are you okay?
我们当中有些团队就看我说你还好吗 ，Peter？
God, let's pray. It's okay.
Okay, 我们祷告。
Oh, shikala la 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 la.
Okay, 内心方言祷告。
And so, I have a clip. We you know, 台湾最有名的是那个 PPAP, 对不对？是什么 PAP？
全世界都很有 PPAP， 没错。
全世界都有名，真的哦，
对，真的。
这种白痴东西红到全世界去了。OK， 好。
我们在传播 PPAP。
But so.We taught them how to pray in Taiwan. 我们就教他们，我们台湾都是这样祷告的。我们说 ，This is my right hand.
这是我的右手。
This is my left hand.
我的左手。
然后就这样带他们祷告。We're not going to show that clip because you know, but we have a clip. 就是我们在 when we're ministering to the police, we're just praying and preaching to them and yeah.
我们有一个短片。
对，我们应该有个短片。I think we do.
就是让大家可以看一下我们在当时怎么样服侍这些警察们。
我们是来自于台湾，你们多少人听过台湾？
Orange, Japan, and 哦，我们问他说你有没有吃过中国式的食物 Panda Express， 他们刚开始有那种美式的中国食物去到他们的国家，然后所以我们就问他们说你有没有吃过中式的食物。那么说其实这些食物都是假的，我们台湾都不吃这些东西，我们是做给你们吃而已。我们说台湾你要知道三件事情，第一个所有来自于台湾的人都知道功夫，他们不相信。那我们就演了一些功夫给他们看。All right. 这影片还蛮长，所以我们停在这。All right. And so that night, we just start, you know, it like looked tough.
那你知道就是一开始有点难。
Because, you know, they know kung fu and I don't know kung fu.
因为事实上真的会功夫的人是他们。
And, but as we just simply, I just share on the grace of God. What is grace?
可是我就开始跟他们分享说神的恩典。
Just a very simple message.
就是很简单的一个信息。
And at the end, people give their life to Jesus.
最后呢，他们就把自己生命交给主。
And they start coming forward.
然后开始来到台前。
By the dozens, coming forward, coming forward.
许许多多人来。
And our team went and embraced him, just pray with him.
团队就为他们一一的祷告。
You know, there's something that I learned everywhere we go.
我们就发现到，不论我们去到哪。
Every nation you go to.
不论你去到哪一个国家。
There's the same yearning in all of our hearts.
在人的心中都有一个同样的渴望。
And it's a yearning to be valued, to be loved, to be treasured.
渴望知道自己是有价值，渴望知道自己能够被爱、被珍惜。
It really doesn't take.Somebody amazing, somebody who is theologically trained to share the love of God.
其实呢，要分享神的爱，不需要一个受过怎么样神学装备的人，或者一个多厉害的人才能分享。
All you need to do,
你唯一需要做的
is to remind people,
就是提醒人
that you're worth it,
让他们知道自己是有价值
that you're loved,
知道自己是被爱的
that there's a heavenly Father,
知道有一位天父
who loves you,
全然爱的
cares for you.
在乎他
created you.
而且创造
You'll be surprised just by sharing a simple message like that.
你会发现当中其实只要一个很简单的信息
How much people's heart will open up and receive.
你会讶异人的心可以如何的对他敞开
And, and this time we had a chance to do leadership training at the church in Guatemala.
那这次我们也有机会在瓜地马拉的教会做领袖
Do you guys want to see our 林良堂在瓜地马拉。
你们想要看一下在林良堂瓜地马拉的影片吗
yeah. You know, it's so cool because most Bread of Life churches, are, you know, Chinese people.
大部分其实我们在海外的分堂都做华人事工。
But this one, it's Guatemalans.
可是这边是全部都是瓜地马拉人。
And it's for the locals, and you know, it's so cool to just see what they have, what God has been doing in that church.
所以在那里真的是服侍当地的百姓，然后我们也很有幸能够看到神是如何在那里
工作。I think we have a short clip, and we'll just show it to you guys.
所以呢，我这是我没有。在别的地方分享过，大家第一次。
我们这次过去，我们跟他们分享怎么样子有一个正确的态度去服侍，去服侍教会，服侍人，服侍神。然后我们有些机会来服侍他们一些弟兄姐妹，他们一些同工觉得很疲倦的一些的同工，所以我们最后有一点时间来服侍他们。我们不唠这就可以，谢谢。 All right, let's give glory to God. God is so good.
掌声归荣耀给神，神真是良善。
It's so good to know we have brothers and sisters, 林良堂的 brothers and sisters in Guatemala.
就是能够知道我们有弟兄姐妹是在林良瓜地马拉的林良堂。
And I really encourage you guys to go to missions.
我渴望，我鼓励大家可以进到短宣里。
Especially cross-culture missions.
特别是跨文化的短宣哦。
对，真的跨 ，Yeah, and it's, yeah.Say, go. Just go on missions.
就是去短宣。
You won't regret it because it's so fun. It is fun.
就是短宣是很有趣。
You know, sometimes we have this idea that missions is like hard, and missions is like you just cannot bathe for a week and different things like.
有时候人们会觉得说短宣好像很困难，然后大概出去过不了一个礼拜就想家。
But it's not true.
可是不是这样的。
I mean, it could be true, but there's a greater truth to that.
有些人可能会这样感觉，但我说有一个更高的真理。
When you go, you'll be surprised how much God can work through you.
因为当你出去的时候，你会讶异神能够透过你行多大的事。
And many times when we go, it's not even so much what God does through us, it's what God does inside of us.
有时候甚至不是神透过我们行了什么，而是神在我们的里面行了多大的事。
You know, every single time when we go, we always have people who are going for the first time.
那每一次去的时候，我们团队总是有人第一次去短宣。
Like this time.Sharon came with us.
那这一次呢，我们当中 Sharon 跟我们一起去。
她是去年才受洗嘛，对不对？
对。
Yeah. She just got baptized last year. 去年才受洗，然后我干嘛要翻成英文给你们听？去年才受洗 ，and 就已经开始去短宣 ，and she was so amazed. 她是我们整个团队的指定按摩师 ，every right. And she shared her testimony. She prayed for 她为人祷告，真的是。
You don't need me,
actually. I don't need you. Please come back. Anyways, we're gonna get into the Word of God today.
好，我们要来看今天神的话语。
Today I want to just share with you a simple message: surrender to grace.
今天我想跟大家分享一个很简单的信息，就是向神的恩典降服。
So Father God, we thank you so much for today.
父神，我们为今天献上感谢。
And tonight we just pray that you would do something wonderful in our midst.
今天我们祷告你行神迹奇事在我们当中。
I just pray that your revelation will flow like a river.
我们祷告你的启示像河流一样流涌流进。
That you will wash away shame.
洗净我们一切的羞愧
and reveal the true treasure that lives hidden in our hearts.
显明在我们心中你所放下的宝藏
In Jesus' name.
奉耶稣的名
All God's people said.
所有百姓神的百姓都说 Amen.
Amen, amen, amen. You know, I am a Chinese kid that grew up in Canada.
大家知道我在加拿大长大，但是我是一个华人的孩子。
And it's not easy to grow up Chinese in Canada.
那你知道，作为一个在加拿大长大的华人，并不容易。
Because people have certain expectations of you being Chinese.
因为人们看到你是华人，就对你有某些期待。
Now I don't know if you know this, but if you're Chinese, if you're a Taiwanese, your math.Skill is probably better than 80% of the world's population.
那我不知道大家有没有知道，可是作为华人或者我们台湾人，通常我们的数学都比全球大概80%以上的人要好。
Right? Like I gotta 告诉你们个 secret， 白人的数学真的是很差，是他们数学真的蛮烂的。So I was I'm Asian, I'm Chinese.
所以我是华人脸嘛。
But I'm one of those Chinese person that God did not bless me with mathematical skills.
可是呢，神就是在数学这方面没有祝福我。
Yeah, just he skip it.
就哎，数学跳过。
He skip a lot of things. Math is one of them. He skip a lot of things.
很多好，就很多东西不好。
跳过去。It's like at least make me good at sport, but he didn't either. So 我就不知道神在想什么。But anyways, but and so when I was now the good thing is this: when I was in No matter how bad you are at math,
那可是你要知道，就算我的数学再怎么不好
，you're still better than 99% of the white kids.
通常
in the math class,
比班上数学班上同学的99%的白人要来得好。
Like you know, so I remember being in school. I was the only Chinese kid in that class.
那我在班上的通常都是唯一的一个华人。
And so I was you know, was good. I people respected me. People thought I was good at math.
所以呢，大家都觉得说，哎，我的数学是确实在他们当中还算不错，那就还蛮尊重
的。And that did give me a sense of validation, a sense of worth.
然后也让我觉得说，哇，很有价值感。
Until
直到
one year
有一年
when another Taiwanese student.
有另外一个台湾来的转学生
，came to my school，
就是转到我们学校
，into my math，
而且就是进到我的数学班上。
你知道我小时候住过台湾，但是我小时候学的学的数学是台北美国学校的数学，那台北美国数学又比真的也是蛮烂的。So you know this guy he grew up in the local school，
那就是他是真的读台湾国小长大的。
So when he came to class，
所以当他来到我班上的时候
，people are now looking at me，
你知道就人们看着我。
Wait, what?
他就想，哎哎，
Oh, your math isn't that great. This guy is math is great.
你的数学也没那么好吗？其他的才比较好。
That's what you're supposed to be like. You're Chinese, right? Why is your
华人不是应该像他一样数学那么好？那你怎么回事
？And so that started a little friendly competition between the both of us.
然后就让我跟那位台湾人同学当中开始一个有性的竞争。
At the end of every class.
那通常每一次结放学后。
At the end, near the end of the class,
就是通常在班上，那堂课快要结束。
We have 10 minutes to do our homework.
我们就是大概会有十分钟要做回家作业。
Because you know it's Canadian school, you know it's easy, so just do your homework first. So, anyways,
加大学制。
And so in that 10 minutes, me and him.
所以呢，在那十分钟，我跟这个同学
，we would look at each other.
我们就会看彼此一眼。
And we would get into a competition.
然后就是你知道开始竞争。
Who can finish the homework fast?
就比说谁可以最快把那个工作做完，功课做完。
Right. And usually every textbook there's about, every chapter there's about 20 questions.
那通常每一课大概是20个问题。
And the teacher would choose from the 20 questions, maybe 5 questions that you have to do.
那老师可能就在20题当中选5题让我们做回家作业。
And as the days went by, I started to realize I cannot do it as fast as this guy. There's just no way. He's just better than me.
比了几次以后，就发现他的数学真的比我好，我就是比不过他。
And so I came up with this brilliant idea.
然后我就想了一个非常棒的法子。
I would do.All the questions beforehand.
我就在每一堂课之前先把那二十题全部做完。
And I will hide the answer.
然后就是把那个
I know, right? It's so nerdy. It's so stupid. You know.
你知道，这当时在想。
然后以前没有女朋友，就没有很多时间，所以 and so that's what I did. And so I didn't know which question the teacher would choose.
可是呢，我又不知道老师到底要选哪五题。
So I would do all 20 questions.
对，二十题全部做完。
Write all the answers down.
把所有的答案都写下来。
And then when the time comes for us to do the homework.
然后等到就老师出作业的时候。
I would, you know, you cannot just copy them all too fast because then it's obvious. I would slowly but faster than that person put on the answer.
但你又不能一次全部抄太快，因为这太明显就作弊。那所以我会慢慢的看好那个速度，可是一定要比他快写完。
And I will always let him know I'm done.
然后呢，就是你知道写完后就一副，
You're still going?
你还没做完呢。哦，不好意思。
三名国小没有好好教你哈。I'm sorry. I'm just too bad, man. It sucks to be you. Wish you were more like me. But you know what?
可是你知道。
That lasted for about, I don't know, 2 weeks.
就是我就是这样比他快，差不多是2个礼拜而已。
And then got very tiring.
然后呢，就发现就是累了。
Because I don't like math.
因为其实我真的不喜欢数学。
I mean, why am I thinking? Why would I do 20 questions when I can just do 5?
我想说，我明明可以写5题就好，我干嘛要做完20题呢
？See, the problem was, I was trying to be somebody that I'm not.
因为你知道，我做那二十题纯粹只是为了做一个不是我自己的
样子。I'm trying to.Do something to achieve something that's not what I am.
我就在尝试要做一个其实我本来不太擅长的事。
And today we're going to look at just one story in the Bible.
今天我们要看圣经当中一个故事。
And it's the story of Jacob.
讲到雅各。
Now I suspect that there's many people in this room that as I share this story, you know exactly what this man is like.
我相信今天当我在分享这个故事当中，我们许多人你会发现到他的生命跟你的生命。
Because you're going to see yourself.
因为你会在他的故事当中。
In this man's story.
看见你自己的影子。
Because I certainly saw myself when I read his story.
因为当我在读他的故事的时候，我也看见自己在他的身上。
Now the story of Jacob started with this passage.
雅各他的故事从这一节经文
开始。我们就直接用中文。我们大家一起来念好，因为21-22比较简单，一起来。
以撒因为自己的妻子不生育，就为他恳求耶和华，耶和华应允了他，他的妻子利百加就怀了孕，双胎在他腹中彼此碰撞。
啊，下一个。
到了生产的时候，
他腹中果然是一对双生子，
先出来的全身赤毛，赤红有毛，像毛衣一样。他们就给他起名叫以撒。
随后，
他的弟弟也出来了，他的手抓住以扫的脚跟，因此就给他起名叫雅各。
You see, the moment that Jacob was introduced into the world,
你知道当 世界在看到雅各这个人的时候
The Bible goes into a pretty detailed description of his birth.
圣经就对他的出生过程讲得非常清楚。
It says that when because it's a set of twins in the mother's womb.
因为讲到说在他母腹中是个双生子。
Esau and Jacob.
是以扫跟雅各。
The mom was about to give birth.
而当母亲要生产的时候
Esau came out first.
是以扫先生出来。
Now in antiquity, especially in Jewish culture, the firstborn son will enjoy favor in the family.
那讲到说就是在犹太人的文化，长子总是带着就是全家人的恩宠。
He would receive a double portion, a double inheritance.
所以他会领受到双倍的恩膏。
So you would want to be the firstborn son.
所以呢，就是会想要做双生子头生的。
Now, if your brother was born maybe 5 years ahead of you,
那如果你的哥哥是早五年出生，
那你就认命嘛。他比你出生早出生五年，他真的是比你 like I mean, God really created him 5 years earlier and.He, you know, and just that mean. But this story is different.
可是呢，这个故事当中不是五年的差距。
In this story, the difference between Esau and Jacob coming out is literally like maybe a minute.
就是在他们两个出生的前后只差了不过一分钟。
But in that 1 minute, it's going to make a distinction between the two boys.
可是呢，那一分钟就造成这两个男孩生命完全大不同。
And so Jacob, even in the mother's womb, they started fighting each other.
所以呢，雅各在母腹当中就直接开始彼此碰撞。
And when the time came to give birth, when Esau came out first,
当出生的时候，以扫先出生了。
The Bible says that Jacob he reached out his hand and he was grabbing his older brother's ankle.
这里讲到说，雅各他居然伸出他的手抓住他哥哥的脚。
That is a freaky scene if you think about it.
如果你仔细想想，这个画面很可怕。
Don't think about it too much.
不要想想起来太。
I mean, this is like Jacob saying to Esau, "Get back in here."
那表示说雅各其实在跟他哥哥说，你给我回来。
I want to come out first.
我要先出生，你进来。
You see, there's something about Jacob, even as a young baby.
你知道，就连他刚出生的时候，有对雅各身上有
a spirit that inside of him that wants to fight to be number one.
在他里面有一个灵，就是努力想要争先。
He wants to be number one.
他想要成为第一个。
And when the Bible says that when he came out,
而所以圣经说当他出生的时候
once he came out, Esau became a hunter.
讲到说出生之后，以扫成了猎人。
And he hunted in the fields and he brought game back for the father.
他在野外打猎以后，会把他打猎的猎物带回来给爸爸。
And Jacob,
而雅各呢
，stayed at home,
就是常在家里。
And became a mama's boy,
成为妈宝。
Right, like it says, the father favored Esau, but Rebecca, the mother, favored Jacob.
圣经里面明明讲到说，父爱以扫，母亲利百加爱子爱。
Whenever his mom would have a tea party,
不论他妈妈就是邀请就是亲朋好友姐姐来到家中喝茶
，Jacob would be there.
雅各一定在旁边
，pouring tea for the aunties.
对，为阿姨们倒茶。
Biscuits.
就是饼干也献上。
小小的三明治。夹心饼干，乖 ，whatever you can think of，
所有这乖乖，就是下午茶需要他都预备好。
But Esau would be out in the fields being a man.
可是呢，以扫就在外面做一个男人在打猎。
And so when Esau comes back，
所以呢，当以扫回到家
，his father would greet Esau.
他的父亲会向以扫打招呼。
But in the father's eye, Jacob seems like he does not exist.
可是呢，在父亲的眼中，以扫雅各似乎完全不存在。
Now.You probably heard this. There are many great people in the Bible, but there are not a lot of great fathers.
我们大家可能听过这样的说法，在圣经当中有许多好人，可是却好的父亲却不多。
There are many models of heroes of faith, but we really don't see a lot of models of good fathers.
讲到许多人他们的信心是怎么样的成为榜样，可是却很少看到作为好父亲的榜样。
This is a classic scenario.
在这里，我们就是看到这样的例子。
Jacob growing up without the father's approval.
雅各他一生成长的时候没有得到父亲的认同。
And whenever you grew up without a father figure speaking to you about your worth and your identity,
在你的成长过程当中，若是没有一个父亲的形象告诉你你的价值
，you will spend your life trying to prove who you are.
你会用尽你的一生，尝试要得到人肯定你这个
人。Because you don't know who you are.
因为过去你不知道
自己是谁。You will spend your life searching for an identity.
你会用尽你的一生去寻找你自己的身份价值。
That is supposed to be instilled inside of you at a young age from a father figure.
但那个价值本当是应在还年幼的时候从父亲那里得着。
So Jacob became Jacob. His name, he who grabs the heel, also means a deceiver.
所以呢，雅各他的名字就是叫雅各的是。是要抓住脚跟的意思，也是欺骗者。
It means the person who deceive to get ahead.
讲到说是要欺哄成为那个在前的。
And so later on, as you read the story,
如果你继续读这故事
you find that one day,
你会发现有一天
Esau came home,
当以扫回到家
having hunted,
就是他已经打猎完
he's famished, he's hungry,
非常的饿
he needs to get some 绿豆汤 he's
红豆汤
红豆汤 it was 八宝粥 I don't know, he needs to eat.
他需要吃东西
And Jacob came along,
雅各就来到他前面
he saw an opportunity.
然后发现说机会来了
You see, whenever you are a conniving little, you always will turn somebody's misery, somebody's problem into an opportunity for you to succeed.
就是当你里面好像充满了一些渴望的时候，你会看见人的机会就抓住他，然后成为使人的不幸成为你的幸福。
Instead of blessing that person, you turn that thing around to benefit yourself.
所以当你看到人的不幸的时候，你不是去祝福他，反而使他的不幸成了你的机会。
So he says to his father, his brother Esau.
对他的哥哥以扫说
，Hey Esau.
他说 Hey Esau.
I'm gonna I got something prepared.
哎，我煮了一些东西。
Can you smell it?
你闻闻味道。
Smells good.
味道还不错哦。
So I'll get you some of that.
我给你一碗怎么样
？Yeah, some chicken soup. Some you know I'll get you.Something good.
我煮了这个好吃的东西。
But,
可是,
but,
可是啊,
sell me your birthright.
你要把你长子的名分卖给我。
Sell me your birthright.
交换给我。
Can we just agree right now that Jacob is being an annoying little brother?
我相信现在大家都同意以扫真的雅各是一个蛮讨人厌的弟弟。
I mean, imagine you have a little sister or a little brother.
你就想象如果你的弟弟或者是妹妹像这
样。And you come home and you're thirsty, you want some water.
你回到家以后就口渴，很想喝水。
And you say, hey, 妹妹，去帮我倒一杯水。And your sister says, "Okay."
就是你要喝水的时候，妹妹说好，我帮你倒。
But
可是，
先签个约，接下来五年的红包你全部要给我。Do you? I mean, let's just agree that Jacob, he's not being a really good brother right now.
我们就相信大家都同意雅各这招不是很不很高明。
And Esau, but Esau despised his birthright. He did not. He didn't care. So he said, "Whatever, you can have it."
可是圣经也讲到以扫轻视他长子的名分，就说啊，给你没关系。
And so Jacob took that birthright.
所以呢，雅各就拿了他长子的名分。
And when the time came for the father, for his father to actually bless Esau,
当父亲要祝福长子以扫的时候
this is what the mother said to Jacob.
妈妈她就对雅各这么说。
Your father is about to bless.
她说，你爸爸
is about to bless Esau.
要祝福长子以扫了。
So go in.
你就进去。
And pretend.
假装。
To be your brother.
你是你的哥哥以扫。
Pretend to be your brother.
假装是你哥哥以扫。
And so what Jacob did?
所以那雅各怎么做？
He put a 羊毛。
他就把毛穿在身上。
你有没有听过狼披着羊毛？ Exactly. He put on that sheepskin, and over him, he went into his father's in the room.
他就把羊皮披在自己身上，进到他父亲的房间。
And when he went in, his father he couldn't see clearly. He says, "Esau, is that you?"
然后进去的时候，父亲眼睛已经看不清楚，问说。以扫是你吗
？And then Jacob, 他的声音可能比较高，说 是我以扫。And he came in and he says, "Let me touch your skin. Let me just make sure it's Esau."
父亲就说：“让我确认一下你是不是以扫，让我摸摸。
”And he touched the skin.
他就摸了他的毛。
And it's 羊毛。
发现是有毛的。
And he says, "Oh, that's Esau."
他想说，是以扫。
以扫真的是很毛哎。I mean, 你真的想，如果你去摸一只羊，说 "Oh, yeah, that's Esau." 毛摸着。怎么这么毛啊？就是你通常不会好奇怪。No, that's Esau, that's my son. You know? So he's like, well, that's my son. All right. And so by pretending to be somebody else,
所以呢，雅各他是假扮为别人。
He received the blessing.
得着了那一份祝福。
He only got a blessing by pretending to be somebody else.
他能够得着祝福的唯一方式就必须假扮成人。
That is not a good place to be in life.
我相信那不是一个人一生所希望经历。
You don't want to be blessed because.
by trying, pretending to be what you are not.
我相信没有人会希望自己要得到祝福的唯一方式，居然是必须假扮成人。
Nobody wants to be applauded by people by pretending to be somebody else.
我相信没有人希望自己能够得到别人的掌声，是唯一当自己做别人的时候。
Nobody wants to be blessed by denying who you are.
我相信没有人是希望。必须要否认自己，这个人才能够得到
祝福。And so at that moment in the life of Jacob,
所以在那个当下，雅各他的生命中
，he thought he had gotten what he wanted.
他以为自己得到自己想要的。
This plan that he spent years conniving and planning, he's got it.
过去那一年，他计划了许久的阴谋，他终于。
Little did he know that at that moment.
可是他却不知道在那个当下。
The moment he pretended to be somebody else.
当他真的假装成为另外一个人。
To get the blessing that he desired.
好，得到那个他渴望得到祝福的时候。
He has set his life in a downward spiral.
他就让他的生命开始呈现了一个往下，就是直线下降的。
Because his name Jacob.
因为他的名字雅各。
Means deceiver.
讲到是骗取者。
But what's happening right now in the story?
但是在这个故事当中所发生的。
Is that he's not deceiving other people anymore?
就是讲到他不再是在骗人。
He's deceiving himself.
他在骗的其实是自己啊。
He's deceiving himself.
他在骗的是自己。
He's losing sight of the person that God actually created him to be.
他失去了一个眼光，不再看见自己神造的自己是什么样子。
And so when the brother came back home and found out that his little brother stole the blessing, he got mad.
所以呢，当哥哥一早回到家中，自己的名分被骗走的时候，他生气了。
And so he ran away.
他弟弟就跑了。
And he 就筋酸了 ，just ran away. 金酸是对吗？金酸是跑路了 ，OK? He ran away and he went to a far away village where his uncle Laban lived.
他就跑到了他的舅舅拉班的地方，住的地方。
And he saw this woman.
他就看到一个女子。
Her name was Raquel.
是拉杰。
Rachel.
拉杰。
And he fell in love with her.
他就立刻爱上了她。
Now there's a whole sermon we can preach on that one, but that's, but we won't. But he fell in love with this lady.
他就与拉杰相爱。
And he said to the father,
他就对拉班说
I will work 7 years for this lady.
我为你工作七年，好娶她。
And so when the time came for him to get the wife,
而当他工作七年要娶妻的时候
the father placed some, switched the thing around.
他的舅舅呢，又用计骗了他。
And trick him,
就骗了他
into marrying her uglier sister Leah.
让他娶了比较不那么漂亮的姐姐莉亚
And it's like buy one get one free, but it's not always what you want, you know.
就是买一送一，可是不一定先拿到自己想要的
And so he knows at that moment.
所以他当下又了解
He knows at that moment.
他发现到
that he's met his match. He met somebody who just out tricked him.
他遇到对手，居然能够骗得了他。
But Jacob,
可是雅各
is Jacob,
还是雅各
Jacob is like, wait a minute.
他就想说，怎么可以这样
？My name is Jacob.
他说，我才是那个骗人的雅各啊。
I mean, 我的名牌上面 literally my name means 骗，就是骗子 ，deceiver. You try to trick me?
他说，我是骗子雅各，你居然想要骗我
？You think you can outsmart me?
你以为你比我聪明
？Let me show you what I'm capable.
让你看看我的能力。
So he devised a brilliant plan.
所以他又想到一个好主意。
He took some sticks.
他就找了一些枝子。
And he cuts them.
然后呢，就削这些树枝。
And to expose the white part of the branch.
就是把树枝那个白色的地方
露出来。So it becomes speckled. It becomes spotted.
就是开始或者是有一些有斑点的。
And he set the branch in front of the sheep that he's feeding.
然后他就把那些枝子插在他喂羊的那些羊的面前。
And the Bible says that as the sheep fed in front of this, all the sheep that fed in front of this became spotted.
然后呢，就讲到说这些在这些树枝前面的羊，它就吃着吃着的时候，身上就开始长出了斑点。
他们生出来，
生出来，
不是身上长出斑点，这有点太
生下来的羊，生下来的羊身上就有斑点。
Yeah. And he said to the father-in-law, he had a deal. All the spotted lamb, all the spotted sheep, it's mine.
他就跟他岳父讲定了说，只要有这些有斑点的羊都是他的。
So from that, he tricked, he basically outsmarted the father-in-law.
所以呢，他就是用计又骗了他的岳父。
He's like, you want to trick me? You want to change my wages? You want to, you know, you want to do all this to me?
他说，你想要骗我？你想要改我的工价？哈，想太多。
I'm going to get what is mine.
我要得到那当属于我。
Because I'm smart.
因为我是够聪明。
Because I have outsmarted everybody else.
我比任何人都聪明啊。
And so the Bible says, you know, all these spotted sheep went to Jacob, and he started having more sheep than the father-in-law.
所以他就想到这些凡有斑点的羊都归雅各之后，他的羊比他的岳父还要多。
Now this outcome caused such a tension between him and his father-in-law that he had to leave the house. He had to run away again.
但是呢，这个结果又使他跟岳父之间有了心结，然后他又必须要逃跑。
Now think about this.
大家要想。
At this moment in Jacob's life,
这个时候雅各他的生命里。
He has destroyed every relationship he's ever had with a father figure.
基本上，他跟所有在他生命当中有父亲形象的人关系都打坏了。
Because he felt like every father figure in his life had disappointed him.
因为他认为他一生当中都受这些父亲形象的人所失望，都让他们失望。
And he thought that he could out-trick every single one of them.
他们都让他失望，而他认为自己能够骗过他们所有人。
And so Jacob, He's got all his sheep, he's got the girl, he's got everything. He feels like, you know what? Nobody's going to outsmart this guy. I got this.
他走到生命这一点的时候，他发现到说，我只要想要的，不论是我的太太，我的羊，我想要我都能得到，谁能够赢得了我？
Yeah, like, you know, like, Jacob, he's at this moment where he believed in himself.
在那个当下，他相信他自己能够办到这一切。
Yeah, he's like, I was born as the not the favorite son.
他说，我虽然出生的时候不是那个最受宠爱的。
Nobody 看好我，没有人看好我。And but you know, through my own street smart, through my own conniving, through my own plans, I have been successful.
虽然没有人看好我，可是我靠着自己的小聪明，我赢过了那些人，我成为最成功的人。
I got a beautiful wife.
你看我的太太多美啊！
I'm gonna bring her home and show everybody.
我要把她带回去，让我家乡的人都看见。
哇，你看，哇，不要看另外一个，but look at this one. You know, look.And look at all the sheep, look at everything. He's about to go back home to his father, to his brother.
他看他所有的羊，然后这样说，我要回到我的家乡，让我的爸爸，让我的哥哥都看见。
And this is a moment where he is faced with the biggest challenge of his life.
可是这也是他生命当中遇到最大挑战的一次。
Because we all know that the last time he saw his brother.
对，大家都还记得上一次他跟他哥哥怎么离开的。
His brother wanted to kill him.
上一次他们两个相见的时候，哥哥是想要杀了他。
He does not know if his brother has changed his mind yet.
他也不知道说哥哥到底有没有改变了心意。
以前没有那个 Facebook， 或是可以就是可以那个传个简讯，可以 line 他，哎，哥哥，你还好吗？you can't write in the, 如果他 send 过来的 sticker 的那个贴图，如果是那，就是先不要回家。But you don't know, like you don't know what's going on. It's been years, and you don't know if he's changed his mind about killing you yet.
虽然已经过了这么多的年，可是他还不知道哥哥到底有没有改变心意，是不是还想杀
他。And we know that Esau is somebody who acts first and think later.
那大家也都知道，Esau是一个想就做事不经大脑的人。
And he's big. He's a hunter.
又非常强壮，是打猎的人。
I managed to get a picture of Esau.
你知道，我就想象Esau大概什么样子。
I have a picture.
我有预备好照片。
下一张。
饶舌歌手。
50 Cent。没有毛，你剃毛。
有刮毛。
毛是可以处理的啦，所以有很多方式，那种拉啊、刮啊、拔都可以。But that's.And I also managed to get a picture.
我也想象了一下
of Jacob.
雅各又会是什么样子？
Let's go back to Esau. 我们再回去看一下 Esau. 我们来看雅各。这个人准备要去见那个人。And the last time they met, 那个人准备要杀这个人。Can you imagine?他的心会有点毛毛的，对不对 ？Okay, so he thinks about, okay, I am Jacob, I got this.
然后就想说，拜托我谁？我雅各哎，可以掌握得了。
You, I have gotten everything I ever wanted in life.
我过去想要的哪一样我没得着
？Nothing can stop me.
没有人能够拦住了我。
So this is what he did.
所以他这么做。
He devised a brilliant plan.
他又想出一个很好的方法。
You have to read the story by yourself, but I'm just.Paraphrasing, he sent out messengers ahead of time.
大家可以再回去读，但是我直接先讲，就是他差派使者先去
to go and talk to his brother.
先去跟他的哥哥谈一谈
Just in case something happened, they would kill the messenger and not him.
就是万一真的有什么事情发生，好歹他杀的是那个信，就是传信的人，不是他自己
Right? And then he said this: When you see my brother,
然后他讲到说，当你见到告诉那个差信的人说你看到我哥哥的时候
，He said this.
他这么说，
你的仆人。雅各这样说， 我在拉班我们的舅舅那边居住，一直到现在，我拥有牛驴羊群，那个是我不知道。现在
啊，仆婢，
仆，哎呀，哦 ，servant 呀、yeah ，现在派人来报告，我主希望得着你的欢心，
欢心，
真的是很欠揍的一个发稿文，对不对？很虚伪的一个，就是他说，以扫，我告诉你，你还以为我那时候逃跑是因为我怕你，其实不是的。你是我的主人，我是你的仆人，我出去是为了赚钱，收集一些羊，你给我十几年的时间，我要带这群羊回来来供，来
献供给你，
来
啊，献供孝敬你，
孝敬你，因为你是我的哥哥，我爱你。哦，这真的是
欠揍，雅各才说得出来
，right？ 只有雅各才说得出这种话 ，right？ 他明明。And this is what he did. He actually sent gifts to go ahead of time.
而且呢，他不光是这么做，他还让这些礼物先送到他的前面。
他 divided up the gifts too.
而且呢，礼物不是一次送。
He did not just send the gifts all at once.
是分批的，不是一次送。
He sent them in waves.
一批的。
Because if you are a man.
因为你要想象，如果你是。
And you've ever pissed up your woman, you know this.
就是你到得罪太太的人，你都知道。
You never give all your gift at once.
就是不能一次就把礼物全部送足。
你一次送完就感觉就只是一次而已。你可以把三个礼物放一次送，他会觉得就只是一个礼物。你要买三个礼物分三次去送，你才会有达到那个效果，而且是要越送越大，你了解我的意思吗 ？You know what I'm talking about, right? You don't just 如果你买一颗钻石，你买一颗车，你买一个什么什么，你全部送，他就觉得就只是一个东西，他会觉得这个珠宝一个 set， 对不对？他只是一个，你买一个项链，买一个钻石，你买一个戒指，他会觉得就是一套而已。你要把它分开来。And that's what Jacob did.
这就是雅各做的方式。
Shoot waves of gift.
就是一波一波的。
He's thinking to himself.
他自己这样想。
I got this. There's no problem I've ever faced in this life that I cannot solve.
我生命当中问题我都解决了。
So he sent the gifts over.
所以就把这些礼物送过去。
And then the messenger came back.
可是呢，拆信的人回到他的。
And this is what the messenger said.
他怎么说？
使者回到雅各那里说：“我们到了你哥哥以扫
那里，
他带着400人
正向迎着你来。”
你不会绕这么多人，除非你是要 you're trying to start something, right? Do you remember the time when David got pissed off at this man called Nabal?
还记得就是大卫被拿巴惹怒的时候他怎么做吗？
You know what David did?
你知道大卫怎么做吗？
He took 400 men.
他就是带着400人呢。
To go kill this guy.
就是要去杀了拿巴。
Jacob is thinking.
那雅各这时候心想
，Oh my goodness.
大计大标了。
他不。因为我的哥哥不可能是带四百个来欢迎我回家 What's going on? Like, I think he's trying to kill me.
就知道说哥哥要杀了自己。
For the first time in his life,
他的生命第一次
his plan doesn't seem to be working out.
好像他的计划不成功了。
He has relied on himself. He has believed in himself all these years.
他过去这些年来相信自己能够搞定一切。
But now that's proven to be false.
可是这一次却
You see, there's a big difference between believing in yourself and believing only in yourself.
你知道，你相信自己跟你相信的只有自己的时候，这两件事是不一样的。
Well, God calls you to believe in yourself.
神叫你要相信自己。
But He never ever calls us to believe only in ourselves.
可是神呼召你不是只有你自己能够相信。
The things that you want to see come to pass in your life.
你希望在你生命当中看到。
You cannot possibly achieve them. By yourself.
你是没有办法单靠自己能够达成的。
But because of the hurt of the experiences that Jacob had,
可是因着雅各生命当中所经到的伤害
he told himself, I cannot trust anybody.
所以他自己知道说，我没办法相信。
Because everybody that I've trusted, everybody that I look up to, they've let me down.
过去我所信靠的人都让我失望啊。
And so he says, I would only trust in myself.
因着他说，我只能相信自己了。
And that's gotten him very far in life up until this point.
那是他好像这样子过了一生的时候，可是今天走到这个地步。
He discovered.
他却发现到。
That he's at the end of his ropes.
自己路好像走到尽头了。
He doesn't know what to do.
他已经不知道该怎么办好。
And so the Bible says this.
因此圣经这么说。
我们看下一章。雅各那夜起来，带着他的两个妻子、
两个婢女和11个孩子，
叫他们
渡过亚伯渡口。他带着他们
先打发他们过河， 然后打发他所要的都过去，只留下雅各一个人。 In the English version it says and Jacob was alone.
英文的版本也是讲到雅各只剩下他自己一个人。
He was alone.
他只有自己一个人。
See, being by yourself,
你知道跟自己只有自己在这里，
can be a very terrifying thing.
有时候可能是很可怕的。
Because while you can trick other people when you are around other people,
因为当你跟别人在一起的时候，你还可以骗得过人。
But when you're by yourself,
但是只剩下你自己一个人的时候，
there's nobody to deceive, there's nobody to trick except yourself.
你能骗得有谁呢？只有自己啊。
In that moment when you come before God by yourself,
而当那个时候你一个人来到神的面前，
the lies in your life,
过去你一生的谎言。
The person that you pretended to be.
过去你假装成为的那个人。
The false identities, false hope, false, you know, worth that you put on.
过去你所披着的那些错误的盼望、错误的期待。
It all becomes unraveled.
都成了就是废去的。
And you're there alone.
只剩下你。
By yourself.
只有你一个人。
And Jacob at this moment.
雅各在那个当下。
He's wondering to himself.
他告诉自己。
How did I end up here in my life?
我怎么走到今天这个地步？
Why? How did I end up at this place?
我是怎么落到今天这个下场？
How did I manage to destroy every relationship that's meaningful?
怎么我生命当中任何有意义的关系都被我给毁了？
How can I have so much and feel so alone?
为什么我有这么多，可是却感觉自己这么孤单？
How is that possible?
怎么会这样子？
It was at this moment of weakness
是在这个他的软弱当下
that the Lord
主
saw.Did you know in the Bible, it never one time ever say Jacob loved God?
你知道在圣经当中没有一次讲到说雅各他爱主。
The only time it says Jacob loved someone is Rachel.
就是唯一讲到他爱的只有拉结。
He was obsessed with her.
那他就是完全被
他迷恋住。But never one time in the Bible did it actually say Jacob loved God.
圣经里面没有一次提到说雅各爱主。
But God loved him.
是神爱他。
And at this moment,
而在那个时候
the God of his father Abraham.
神成为他父亲雅各的父亲的神
，Isaac，
他父亚伯拉罕
，The God of Abraham, Isaac is now about to become the God of Jacob。
那位亚伯拉罕、以撒的神，今天要成为他的主。
I'll say it again, the God of Abraham。
我再说亚伯拉罕的神
，The God of Isaac，
以撒的神
，At this moment，
在这个当下
，is about to become
要成为
the God of Jacob，
雅各的神。
And so God sent an angel.
因此神差派天使
to minister, to tend to this broken son.
去服侍这个心灵破碎的儿子
This man who has destroyed everything in his life.
过去他一生当中所有一切东西，他都被他毁了
This Father in heaven.
这位天父
The only Father that does not disappoint.
那个不让他失望的那位父
sent an angel.
差派一位天使
to go bless Jacob.
要去祝福雅各。
But Jacob being Jacob.
可是呢，就是不管走到哪里，雅各还是雅各。
When he saw an angel show up,
当他看见一个天使来到他面前
，he decided
他居然决定
to get into a wrestling match with this man.
要跟他摔跤。
Can we just agree that is weird?
大家可以同意吗？这真的很怪。
这是一个很奇怪的一个故事。I mean, imagine this is that.Jacob, he's there all alone, crying, weeping, praying. He's asking, "What's going on? Why am I like this?"
我们刚刚大家都知道，雅各在那里独自一人，然后哭求的说：“主啊，我到底做了什么，落到今天这个下场？”
An angel of the Lord showed up.
然后一个从主来的天使在他面前
says, "Jacob,
叫做雅各
The Lord has heard you.
主听见你的呼求
He has sent me.
主差派我来到你的面前
And then Jacob just grab onto him.
然后他讲完，然后他又拉着他，把他往下拽
Bless me, bless me, bless me.
祝福我，祝福我
Wait, I am.
天使说我。
Bless me. I will not let you go unless you bless me. You better bless me. You better bless me. Shut up. Bless me. Because that's the only way Jacob knew how to get a blessing. Jacob does not know how to receive something. He only knows how to wrestle something away from someone.
过另外一个人，好叫他得到。
He had to wrestle his blessing away from his father.
他必须要从他父那里骗取这祝福。
He had to wrestle his blessing away from his father-in-law.
他必须要跟他的岳父拼斗。
And he thinks if God wants to bless me, I need to wrestle that away from him.
他的心中认为说，如果神要祝福我，那我必须先赢过他才可以。
Because sometimes you might know that you are loved by God.
因为有的时候你会以为你知道神爱你。
But you don't think he actually wants to bless you.
可是却不真认为神要祝福你。
You actually don't think he wants to prosper you.
你也不认为神是要使你丰盛的。
And you think,
你以为
in order to receive the fullness of life,
唯一能够领受那丰盛生命的方式
you have to wrestle it,
就是要就扭
fight for it,
必须要拼斗
from God,
才能够从神那里得着。
And he wrestled with this man.
所以他就跟这个人摔跤。
This is one of the weirdest story in the Bible.
这真的是我圣经里面看过最诡异的故事。
What kind of person wrestle with an angel?
到底是谁会想出这个想都要跟天使摔跤？
I mean, 就算他不是天使 ，What kind of person wrestle with a strange man?
就是根本不认识他，然后一来就直接跟他拼。
That's weird.
真的很怪。
That's weird, man. There's something messed up about this guy. So he starts wrestling him.
所以呢，雅各就是开始跟他。
And the Bible says that the daybreak, you know, the sun was coming up.
他们摔倒了一整夜，然后阳光正要起来。
And the angel finally said.
最后天使说。
All right.
他说好了。
Enough of this.
够了。
I gotta go back.
我必须要回去啊。
Right. I'm assigned to sing Hallelujah today, so I need to go back and say. I need to go sing like holy, holy, the third holy that's supposed to be me today.
今天我排班要去唱圣哉圣哉圣哉，等一下要轮到我了。
第三个圣哉是应该我唱的。I need to get back. So and none of this nonsense.
所以呢，我们这些闹够了。
And he tapped Jacob on the side.
他就摸了雅各大腿窝一把。
And he went limp.
然后他就瘸了腿。
Jacob at that moment discovered something.
那个时候雅各发现到。
You see, Jacob thought he was.Beating this angel.
因为雅各以为自己原本是占上风，在打这个天使。
He thinks he's winning the match.
他以为他在占上风。
Let me ask you. Let me just ask you a question. It's not a trick question.
我问他一个问题，我不是要骗你们哦。
When an angel gets in, 如果一个天使跟一个人类摔跤，如果你要赌的话，你会赌谁赢？天使 ，right? 因为天使可以摧毁整个城市。I mean, they'd be known to destroy cities. They can do a lot of things. You would bet your money on the angel, wouldn't you?
所以不管怎么样，我们一定是赌天使赢嘛。
Because the angel is powerful.
因为他是非常有能力的。
But the Bible says here that the angel did not overcome him.
可是呢，圣经却没有讲到说天使以力胜过他。
Until he just touched him on the side.
直到最后是摸了他大腿。
你像那种功夫 panda 啊，打那种死穴 ，boom， and then say, oh.And then 他才说 ，Oh my goodness！
然后他才发现到，
你有这一招哦，
原来这么厉害。
I mean, we were wrestling all night, and you could have just killed me.
一整夜这样拼斗下来，其实你早就可以杀了我。
You could have destroyed me. You could have flown me. You could have pulverized me.
从一开始就让我整个人麻痹都有可能。
But you didn't.
可是你却没有这么做。
Because God does not deal with us according to our sins.
神不是按着我们的罪在处理我们。
He doesn't deal with us according to what we deserve.
他也不是按着我们配的方式来对付我。
That's called grace.
这叫做神的恩典。
And he realized something.
他就明白到。
God has been dealing with me in grace all this time.
一直都是用着恩典在对我这个人。
You think you can beat me?
你以为你可以打得过我
？No.
才不是嘞
I'm being patient with you.
我是对你有耐心
Jacob, you think you had all these blessings in your life because you hustle and you got it?
雅各，你以为你过去难道这些祝福都是你自己拼来的吗
No.
不是的，雅各
Because I love you, that's why I bless you.
所以我爱你，所以才
让你祝福到你。 You think you were so smart and you cut some branches and you made some white sparks. You think that is the reason why your sheep came to you?
雅各，你以为你是你的小聪明，让这些羊身上出了斑点，然后都是因为你才做成的。
You think that branch with you, that scientifically stupid.
你真的以为是那些斑点树枝的斑点让羊身上长出斑点？
That does not make sense, Jacob.
一点都不合理。
You think that's the reason why you were blessed?
那些羊就让你
That was stupid. You don't know this yet because you don't know science, but it is stupid.
很抱歉，你是因为不懂科学这么想，可是这太蠢了。
But you got it because I work behind the scene.
你之所以能够得到这些，是因为我在背后使这一切成就。
See, you think you had all these successes in life.
你以为过去这些生命当中的成功
？Because of you.
是因着你自己吗
？But no.
雅各不是的。
It's because of me.
是因着我。
Because I'm a God of grace.
因为我是充满恩典的神。
Because I'm your father.
是因为我是你的父啊。
I'm the God of your father Abraham.
我是你父亚伯拉罕。
Isaac.
以撒。
And right now, Jacob.
现在要做你雅各的神。
Would you let me be your God?
你让我做你的神好吗？
Would you let me be your God?
你是不是可以让我做你的神？
Would you surrender to this grace?
你是不可以降服在这恩典之下？
And the angel asked him a question.
最后天使问他一个问题。
What is your name?
他说你叫什么名字？
What is your name?
你的名字叫什么呢？
And Jacob said,
雅各说
Jacob,
我叫雅各
Jacob,
雅各
For the first time in his life,
你知道在他生命当中头一次
He admitted who he was.
他终于承认自己到底是谁
He's not pretending to be Esau.
没有在假装自己是以扫
He's not pretending to be somebody's favorite son.
没有在假装自己是哪一个人所爱的儿子
He's not pretending to be anybody else.
没有在假装自己是别人
He says,
他说
I'm Jacob.
我是雅各
I'm a liar.
我是个欺骗者。
I'm a cheat.
我是欺骗人。
I destroy every relationship I ever had.
所有的关系我都毁了。
I'm Jacob.
我是雅各。
And I'm asking you.
那我问你。
To bless me.
可以求你祝福我吗？
Bless me as Jacob.
求你按着雅各来祝福我。
And the angel said.
天使说。
Your name.
你的名字。
Will no longer.
将不再叫做。
Be called Jacob.
雅各。
I'm giving you a new name.
我要给你一个新的名字。
Your name from this day forward.
从今天开始。
Will be known as.
你要叫做。
Israel.
以色列。
The Prince of God.
就是神的王子。
The Prince of God.
是神的王子。
The Prince of God.
是神的王子。
Jacob finally came to a place of surrender.
最后雅各终于降服。
He finally realized.
他也终于明白到。
That his life
他的一生
is not about what he can do.
不是他能够成就什么
It's not about what he can accomplish.
不是他能够做成什么
Because everything, every time you feel like it's all about you,
因为每当你想到说都是要
it will always require you to pretend to be somebody else.
你必须要假装成为另外一个人才能做
Because I got news for you, friend.
但是我有告诉你一个好消息
The plan and the purpose that God has for you,
神对你的生命的计划
The dream and the vision.
他所有的意向和梦想
that he has for you,
他为你所预备的
is too big for you to just be you and achieve it.
你要做自己来成就这些是不可能，因为那是
太大。There's no way you can do it.
没有办法靠自己完成的。
You need to get a new name.
你必须要有个新的名字。
You need to take on a new identity.
你必须要有个新的身份。
And if you don't get that new identity, new name from God, you're going to get it from somewhere else.
如果你没有办法从神那里领受一个新的名字或身份，你必须要从别人。
You're going to look at someone else that you admire. You're going to look at someone else that you think has it all, and you're going to pretend to be that person.
你会从别人的身上，你以为他拥有一切，然后你就要想要成为那个人来得着他有的一切。
While all the while, God just needs you to say.
可是神需要你做的唯有一件事。
I'm Jacob.
就是说你是谁？我是雅各。
I'm Peter.
我是彼得。
I'm Ada.
我是 Ada.
You just need to be you.
你只需要做自己。
And when you admit that you're you,
当你承认自己是
somebody who's broken,
就是承认自己是破碎的
somebody who's in need,
承认自己是有需要的
a new name,
一个新的名字
will be given to you,
就会加给你。
Can we stand up on our feet?
每个人都从座位上站起来。
Holy Spirit,
圣灵。
We bless you, Lord.
主啊，我们赞美你。
We thank you, Lord.
主，我们感谢你。
Holy Spirit, we thank you for speaking to us today.
圣灵，今天感谢你对我们说话。
And I just pray all over this place right now.
今天我要做这个祷告。
That no matter who they are,
不论在场的是谁。
That at this moment in their life, they will stop pretending.
今天在这里，他们要不再假装成为另外一个人。
They will stop pretending.
他们不要再继续假装。
Because who?You call us to be.
因为你呼召我们要成为。
And the vision and the dreams that you have for us.
你所为我们预备的意向和梦想。
Does not require us to be somebody else.
不是要我们做别人。
It just requires us to be honest with where we are.
只需要承认自己现在在哪里。
That we just have to admit this is who I am.
我们只是需要承认自己现在是谁。
A man, a woman who is broken, who is in need of you.
承认自己是一个破碎需要你的人。
And I just need you, God.
神，我唯一需要的就是你。
And so right now, in the name of Jesus, Lord,
现在奉献，奉
献。Would you speak into their hearts?
求你对我们的心说话。
I want to speak to all people, every single, all the people here right now who.I want to speak all to all the people here right now that when you were growing up,
我想要对我们当中每一个等一下即将要走出去的人说
all of you who when you were growing up, you thought you have to be somebody.
在我们成长过程当中，若是你曾经认为自己要成为另外一个人
you thought that in order to have the life that you want, you have to be somebody else.
你认为说必须要拥有你想要的生命，是唯有当你假装成为另外一个人才能得。
I want to speak to you.
如果这是你。
My friend, I want to say that's not true.
我想告诉你，这不是真的。
And I break that lie off right now in the name of Jesus.
我现在要奉耶稣的名破除这样的话。
I want to speak to all those people.
我想要对我们当中人说。
All of you who have tried and you tried and you tried.
就是你过去靠着自己不断不断努力的。
And you've gotten a lot of what you wanted.
然后好像看起来你拥有一些你想要的。
But there is that one thing.
可是唯有一件事。
The thing that you truly need, you truly want.
就是你真正需要、真正渴望。
The true desire of your heart.
在你内心里面一个真实的渴望。
You just can't seem to have.
你好像怎么样都无法得到它。
Because that thing is never supposed to be yours through your work.
因为那完全不是透过你手能够成就的。
It's supposed to be yours through grace.
是单单靠着神的恩典能得着。
You see, if you can understand that what you have is not because of your work.Then you would not work to keep what you have.
如果你知道你能够得着一切不是靠着你的努力，那你就不会再尝试要用努力来得着。
If you know that what you have is because of the grace of God,
如果你知道你能拥有一切都是靠着神的恩典
，then you would keep on believing and trusting in the grace of God to sustain where you are at.
你就会持续的靠着相信神的恩典来过接下来的一生。
And I'm speaking to all the people.
今天我要对所有人说。
To all the people right now,
对我们当中所有人说
who are just tired,
那些你感觉到疲惫的
who is tired to pretend to be somebody that you're not,
对于要继续假装成为一个不是自己的人，你已经感觉到厌倦的
stop pretending,
不要再继续假装
just be you,
就是单单做自己
just be you,
就是做自己
in Jesus' name,
奉耶稣的名。
我们结束的时候 I want to pray for some of you guys.
我等一下为一些人来祷告。
We're going to have our team, our, 我们的牧者团队还有我们的祷告团队来这边服侍我们弟兄姐妹。我想要告诉 I want to ask you if you need prayers.
如果是你需要被祷告。
如果今天所讲的 You know I'm talking about you.
你知道我今天所说的就是你。
你知道当你在听着故事的时候你知道 Oh man, that's me.
你在听这些故事的时候你心里知道说这在对你说话。
I want you to come forward.
我想你来到台前。
我要你现在开始来到台前。当我们在敬拜团在唱这首歌的时候，我要你来到台前。Just come, just come, just come. It's okay, it's okay.
无论你在哪里，
就是来到台前。It's okay, it's okay. Just come, just come, just come, just come.
来到台前。
Jesus, come on. Oh, 我神。我的心单单渴慕敬拜你，天使围绕，带领我看见你。
主
圣灵，主圣灵，
继续来到台前。
主圣灵，轻轻呼唤着我的姓名，黑暗中，你爱牵引着我。我神，我的心单单渴慕敬拜你，天使围绕，带领我看见你。是他上担当我罪和羞愧，忍受鞭伤，交换我生命。是流回顾我的前行，与我同在，是我坚定。主圣灵，主圣灵，轻
经呼唤着我的生命，黑暗中你爱牵引着我。哦，我神，我的心单单渴慕敬拜你，天使围绕带领我看见你。十架上担当我罪和羞愧，忍受鞭伤交换我生命，恩典之流恢复我的洁净，与我同在使我坚定，主的爱穿越高山直到地下，恩惠阳光在这地，恩典之流敬畏中我站立，慈爱怜悯淹没我的心。
好不好？我们在座位的每一个人，如果你没有来的也没关系，我们现在I just want to pray for you guys， 想为你们大家做一个祷告，好吧？我们大家继续闭起我们的眼睛。Father God, we just come before you. We thank you for this moment. We thank you that at this moment right now, that there is one voice that we're tuning into. And that is the voice of our Father. I thank you that every single person in this place, from the front to the back, on the first level and the second level, no matter who they are and how long they've been in church,It doesn't even matter if they're a Christian. Every single one of them right now can hear your voice. And I believe, Father God, that at this moment, you are speaking to your sons and your daughters. That you are speaking to them. Words of affirmation. Words of love. Words of identity. You are reminding them of who they are. That all you are asking them right now is to be honest. It's to be alone before you. Without all the titles and all the pretensions. Just to be them. Being them is a beautiful thing. It's a beautiful thing to be you. Be who you are. That's all God requires. So right now at this moment, God, as I stand before you, would you speak to them? What is the Holy Spirit speaking to you? Just begin to process that. Just kind of just meditate on that. See, God is speaking to people all over this place right now. Whoa.God is speaking, whoa, God is speaking. There are years of shame that's going to come on them right now in the name of Jesus. There are years of shame that you have carried, it's going to come on them right now in the name of Jesus. Shame is from what you think you had to be. What things that people have done to you and said to you. Shame are going to come on them right now in the name of Jesus. I see shackles of shame being broken all over this place. Tune into the voice of God right now. See, ignore everything else that's going on around you. Don't worry about the person next to you right now. This is a moment between you and your Father. This is a moment between you and your Father. And your Father is speaking to you. He's speaking to you. He's speaking to you. He's speaking to you. He's speaking those sweet words of love. He's speaking to you.
他在对你说话。
He's reminding you.
他在提醒你。
Of who you are.
告诉你你是谁。
Yeah. Yeah.
他在告诉你。
Yeah. Over this place.
在每一个地方。
All over this place.
在这里的每一处。
Such a beautiful moment.
何等美好。
So beautiful to listen to the voice of your Father.
能够听见父的声音何等美好。
Oh, his voice is beautiful.
他的声音多么甜美。
He's speaking to you.
他正在对你说话。
So let him speak.
让他继续对你说话。
Spend a few more seconds.
再花一些的时间来聆听。
Holy Spirit.
圣灵。
What are you saying?
圣灵在说什么？
Yeah.Yes, Lord.
是的，主。
Yes, Lord.
主啊，是的。
Yes, Lord.
主是的。
Yes, Lord.
主是的。
Yes, Lord. Yeah. Yeah. Yes, Lord.
主啊，是的。
Yeah.
主是的。
Jesus, Jesus,
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
It's okay. It's okay.
没有关系。
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 He knows.
他知道。
He knows.
他知道。
He knows.
他知道。
It's okay.
没有关系。
如果你还有需要祷告的，当我们最后在唱这首诗歌的时候，你可以来到台前，让我们的同工继续来服侍你。如果没有的话，今天的聚会到这个马上结束，让我们继续来敬拜。
十架上担当我罪和羞愧，人手边上交换我生命，恩典之与我同在，使我坚定。主的爱穿越高山，直到地极，赐下恩惠，阳光在彻底。站立，慈爱怜悯淹没我的心，此生充满主恩典，因你宝血心事完全，我渴望见你容面， 说你奇妙柔美，此生充满主恩典，因你宝血心事完全，我渴望见你容面，诉说你奇妙柔美。十字架上，十字架上担当我罪和羞愧，忍受鞭伤交换我生命，恩典只留回不我的结晶，与我同在是我坚定。
主的爱，
主的爱穿越高山直到地极，赐下恩惠阳光在彻底，恩典之流敬畏中我站立，慈爱怜悯淹没我的心。
我们今天聚会到这里，我要再次邀请，如果您是第一次或第二次来到我们当中的新朋友，可以邀请你到我们外面的219教室，好，我们会有同工进一步能够来帮助你认识我们的教会跟牧区。另外呢，我们要特别为我们当中有一些身体方面有需要被祷告，或者是你渴望能够再次出来被服侍的，我邀请你在这个时候让神的灵能够来触摸你的身体。